And right, we'll see this question. Puta, this is from the break-even analysis, cost volume profit analysis. An educational institution is planning to introduce an English course in Colombo, and it will be conducted in a rented premises. The time durations of the course is 3 months, right? Expected income and the cost they have given. Registration fees per student 5,000. Monthly course fees 3,000. In total, it's 9,000. We'll see what that is. Examination fees is 2,000. Right, expenses, lecture fees 100,000 per month. Assignment marking fees 1,000 per student. Building rent 12,000 per month. Tutorial cost 2,500 per student. Monthly salary 10,000. Advertising expenses 50,000. Operating expenses 84,000. Right. Now you are required to calculate the contribution per unit. Puta, it is very much important when you identifying these, right? Before you doing this, to the identifications, right? Identifications of the variable, right? What, so then what on what you consider as the volume of these particular questions, right? So we are doing the cost volume profit analysis now. So what is the volume, right? Now in this question, you can say your number of outputs will be the number of students. Therefore, if there is anything, right, if there's any cost that will proportionately change based on the number of student, based on the number of student, that only you identified as what, Puta? A variable cost. Got it? Now here there are many variables. No, so then they, it says this has 3 months, right? It says this has 3 months. Understand what I said? So then month also would be changed, right? Again, month wise, even some expenses would be changed. Now for an example, building rent would be monthly change. So even though it's changed on monthly basis, proportionately that building rent you want identified as what? Variable cost. You identify what is the what exactly the sales volume or the revenue volume, right? So then in this situation, that is the number of students. How do you determine that? Look at the requirement of the questions. You wanted to calculate the break-even point in number of units, and you wanted to calculate the contribution per student, right? Contribution per students. In such case, it is very, very clear you wanted to calculate what? Contribution per unit per student. So then student will be the main variable that you need to consider, right? Okay, with that idea, shall we move into the answer? It says contribution per unit, right? Okay, Buddha, when it's come to the contribution per unit, how are you going to calculate the contribution per unit? Contributions, how are you going to calculate? Selling price minus average variable cost. Now when you take the selling price, it has to be, you have to very clearly identify. Selling price means income per student. Puta, here the income per student, how much? From a student, you are charging 5,000 as a registration fees, right? Selling price is what? That from a student as a from a student as a registration fees, how much you gonna collect, Puta? Rupees 5,000. Is that clear for you? Yes. And the course fees is how much? 3,000 per month, but from a student you are charging 9,000. From a student you are charging how much, Puta? Rupees 9,000. Keep in mind, right? So then you don't take the monthly fees. A student can again work up charge. That is 9,000. Okay, take that. Right. And then the examination fees, you're charging from a student, which is rupees 2,000. Right. And how much the total revenue that you charge? So then, as this is a service organization, we call this as a revenue rather than saying the selling price. And how much is your total income, Puta? Is it 16,000? Right? Contribution per unit is rupees 16,000. And then you need to find out the revenue per student is rupees 16,000. Then you need to find out the variable cost. Okay, Puta. How much is the variable cost? What is the cost that will be proportionately vary based on the number of students? Lecturers' fees, will it be changed? No, that is per month, right? That is per month. But the assignment marking fees per student 1,000. Assignment marking fees per student, that is 1,000. What next? Bill need rent 12,000 per month. Okay, tutorial that is a monthly cost, fixed cost. But tutorial cost 2,500 per students. We assume for all 3 months, tutorial cost. How much it is? 2,500 per student. And then manager salary, it's on monthly basis, advertising expenses, operating expenses, all these are the maybe for 3 months, but it's not a variable cost. And about how much the variable cost that is supposed to recognize here, the entire variable cost that you recognize is 3,500. Is your answer correct? Is your answer correct? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, 12,500. Yes, contribution per unit. Rupees 12,500. Right. We are giving 4 marks for it. How do you get? For this registration fees, we are giving 0.5, and for this also we are giving 0.5, but for this we are giving 1, right? For this also you are giving 1 each, right? So you get 4 marks. A contribution per unit is how much? Contribution per student 4. What next? Number of students required to cover the total cost, which means they are asking the break-even point. Okay, break-even point, how are you going to calculate, Puta? BEP equal total fixed cost divide by contribution per unit. Okay, Manikyan Puta, how much is the total fixed cost? Right. When you are doing the break-even analysis, the most important assumption that you want to know is any cost other than the variable cost is a fixed cost. Right, in the cost volume profit analysis, that simple assumptions you should know when you are doing these questions, right? Accordingly, Puta, lecture fee, lecturer's fee, you need to consider as a fixed cost. How much it is? Don't forget, you are doing this question for 3 months. It's got a monthly lecturing fee, 100,000, right? 100,000 into 3, is it 300,000? For the 3 months period, it is 300,000 lecturer's fee. Then the assignment marking fee we consider as a variable cost, but the building rent, how about the building rent, Puta? Monthly rent is 12,000. Then for 3 months, it is 36,000. Tutorial cost, that is a per student cost, which is a variable cost, but the manager's salary. मत क्या पता मैनेजर सैलरी 10,000 per month, then for 3,000, for 3 months it is 30,000. And advertising expenses, they have given for the entire 3 months period. Advertising expenses, they have given for 3 months, which is 50,000. And operating expenses. $84,000. Right, in a total fixed cost is how much? Rupees 500,000. Right, so the total fixed cost Rupees 500,000. Right, contribution per unit 12,500. Then 500,000 divided by 12,500. 500,000 when you divide by 12,500, it's 40 students. You get 40 students. Clear? Yes. How the marks will be allocated here? Puta, you are giving half a marks for each. Maximum 2 marks. Huh? You can give only 2 marks for every calculations here, for every figure here. You are giving 0.5, but the maximum has to be 2 marks. Maximum 2 marks. Clear now? Yes. And then for the contribution per unit, you are, if this 12,500 was recorded, you allocate another marks altogether 3, plus for the final answer you are giving another mark. That's how you got 4 marks for this break even point. 0.4 per 0.5 per one here, then you are getting the total 2.5. All are correct, 2.5 marks, but you are getting only maximum 2 marks. The 2 plus this 12,500, 1 plus this 1, it's 4. Right. And then if only 60 students were registered, calculate expected profit. Very clear. You can calculate expected profit. Okay, Puta, profit, how are you going to calculate? Keep in mind, in a situations where you calculate the break-even point, profit could be very easily calculated. How? Margin of safety into yen. Contribution per unit. But again, how much is the margin of safety? Puta, in a situation where you calculate the break-even point, profit could be very easily calculated. You know that more than the break-even point, whatever the units you sold, more than the break-even point, whatever the units you sold, generated, contribute, the contribution that is generated from those units, basically you can consider as a cost. Sorry, basically you can consider as a profit. So then margin of safety into contributions. How much is your margin of safety? It's 20. Contribution per unit is how much? 12,500. Then how much is your profit? 12,500 into 20, is it 250,000? Yes, 250,000. You are giving 4 marks for the margin of safety calculation 2 and contribution applications of the contributions here 1, right? For the margin of safety, it's 2. Applications of the correct amount of contribution, it is 1. And for the final answer, it is 1. Right. Next up. Number of students to be enrolled to the course to earn a profit of 400,000. Okay. Puta, if you want to generate a profit of 400,000, how many students should participate? How much is your fixed cost? Your fixed cost is rupees. Is it 400,000? Yes. Your fixed cost is rupees 400,000. How much is the expected profit? How much is the expected profit? Sorry, your fixed cost is not 200, it's 500,000, right? And your expected profit is rupees 400,000. So how much the total contribution that you wanted to generate? How much the total contribution that you wanted to generate? to have a profit of 400,000, right? For you to have the profit of 400,000, you should have a contributions of 900,000. You should have a contribution of 900,000. So the contribution of 900,000 you have to generate in total. Contribution per unit, how much? Contribution per unit is how much? It's 12,500. Yes. And aputa, to generate 900,000, how many students should participate? I didn't apply this directly to the formula, right? For you to give the knowledge only, I did these particular elaborations. 900,000. Always keep in mind your total contributions equal fixed cost plus profit, right? Fixed cost plus profit. There are 900,000 when you divide by 12,500, it's 72 students. 72 students. If 72 students participate, what could happen? If 72 students participate, you will earn a profit of 400,000, right? Here, for this contributions, you get 2, 1, and 1. Sum of the students might have done this, number of students equal what? Total fixed cost plus expected profit divide by contribution per unit, right? Some of the students might have done this. Make up karala athi samahara kattiya ekama deene same thing, right? Etoda for this calculations you are giving, for this calculations you are giving 2 marks, for this you are giving 1 mark, and number of students for the final answer you got another 1 mark. Clear now, right? Okay, last one. Calculate the minimum course fees for the period of 3 months to be charged from a students. If the expected profit and the number of students participate, how much? 400,000 and 100 students, right? Very clearly you can do the calculations, right? Puta, expected profit is how much? Same thing you can apply. Expected profit 500,000. Clear? Hurry. Then the total fixed cost is how much? How much the total fixed cost? Also rupees 500,000. Is that clear? So then how much has to be the contribution? So the contribution comes to rupees 1 million. Yes. Right. Now this 1 million must be earned with how many students? With 100 students. The number of students Hundred. Enaputa, contribution per student, required contribution per student, how much? 1 million divide by 100. 1 million divide by 100. Then when you remove the last two digits, it has to be 10,000 rupees. Currently, contribution per unit is 12,500. Currently contribution per unit is 12,500. But now your contribution has to be how much? 10,000. Puta, they required you to calculate the selling price. Selling price is equal what plus what? Selling price is equal what plus what? Contribution plus average variable cost. Tell me, Puta, what is contribution? That is rupees 10,000, required contribution 10,000, and the average variable cost we calculated, that is constant at any level of production. That is the nature of the variable cost. Average variable cost is constant, which was rupees 3,500. That is rupees 3,500. Right. Okay, then altogether, If you are charging rupees 13,500 from a student, if you are charging rupees 13,500 from a student, right? What could happen? You can generate 100,000, sorry, 400,000 profit. You can generate 400,000 profit with 100 students, right? That's it.